And I have such horrible handwriting that even it escapes me. These poets and their poems in which they live through a fantasy of killing you. Lethal to a lover, shots at a bad father or mother, assassinations of whole congresses for presidents' transgresses. You'd think a poet harmless, you'd think a poet harmless, not a deadly threat. But if you've been killed in their verses, you'd know not offending is a far safer bet. Oh, there's nary a trigger getting pulled. But if you feel safe, don't get fooled. You'll still feel like you're gathering a bloody pool if you cross your poet. Feel lucky that there's art, a bullet for you in my line. But you'll still feel my heat if you crossed me too many times. No, my poem doesn't say, see, I don't usually kill people in my poem. Maybe I should have that fantasy play out a few times, because I've got a graveyard full. No, my poem doesn't say bam, but consider this a thing. They kill you in their phrase, but you'll be alive when they leave the stage. But my lines will just leave you winged. So do you worry if the reciprocal is a real thing? Nah, don't worry. I'm the peaceful sort. Or maybe I just don't want to be on a report. Well, I certainly don't do it for sports. So you can probably assume you're safe. No one I've ever killed complains.
See what y'all did?
All teasing aside, there's a matter of pride. Hey. No one's ever died, because death means no chance to learn to cope. It robs us both of our only hope. And so that you learn and improve. Oh, it robs us both of any hope that you would learn and improve tomorrow. So, thank you.